This video is based on ant colony optimization algorithm, and in this video we will try to understand how we can solve traveling salesman problem using ant colony optimization algorithm step by step with numerical example. As you can see here in part 1, we already discussed what is ant colony optimization algorithm. You can check the link in the description or in the comments. In this video we already discussed what is this algorithm all about, how it is working, its mathematical model. For more details, you can watch this video. Now in this video, we will try to understand how we can solve traveling salesman problem using ant colony optimization algorithm. As you can see here, we have a salesperson, this one, and four cities, one, city two, city three, and city four. This salesperson want to visit all the cities and then return to the turn city. And during this tour, this salesperson want to cover minimum distance. So we need to find out the feasible tour for the salesperson that cover minimum distance. And here constraint is each city should be visited exactly once. Now we will apply ant colony optimization algorithm to find out the feasible tour for the salesperson. For that, first we will construct the graph and we will consider city as nodes. And here you can see the edges, that is the distance between the two cities. You can see the edge, that is edge. So first we will construct the graph that is complete, connected and undirected. Just imagine we have a Santa here and he lives somewhere in the space, and on Christmas Santa want to visit all the countries on earth, and constraint is here Santa want to visit each country exactly once. So find out the shortest route for Santa that cover minimum distance. Just imagine. Now we will try to understand how we can solve traveling salesman problem using ant colony optimization algorithm with numerical example. First step is the parameter initialization phase. Here we will initialize all the important parameters that are required. Here we are using the population size, that is the number of artificial ants. We have 4, maximum iteration 10, pheromone evaporation rate 0.05, and for first iteration we will use artificial pheromone value, that is 0.0453 for all the routes. And after this iteration we will update the value for the artificial pheromone for each route, but in the first iteration we will consider this constant value for all the routes, and you can see the constant here. Now in step 2, calculate the objective function value. Here we will calculate the value for each route. Here the fitness value is the sum of the edge weights during the tour, and we will calculate the edge weights in upcoming steps. Now here our goal is to construct the feasible solution. Feasible solution means feasible tour for the salesperson. Now step 3 is construct the solution for each ant. Now how we can construct the solution for each ant? First, for any ant we will select the city randomly. After that we will build the tour from the randomly selected city to the unvisited cities. And here ant have memory to store visited cities. And once all the cities are visited, we will return the ant to the randomly selected city. Now we will start the solution construction phase for the 4 ants. Here you can see in the graph the position for the each city. First city, for the first city you can see the value x1, y1 here. Second city x2, y2 here. Third city and fourth city. Now here we have 4 cities, and now we will calculate the distance between each city. And you know the distance formula. Using this distance formula, we will calculate the distance between all cities. As you can see here, we calculated the distance between first city and second city. So put the values here, x2 minus x1. x2 is 28, x1 is 9. Plus y2 minus y1, that is 75 minus 76, and we got the distance between first city and second city is 19.02629. As you can see here, we calculated the distance between city 1 and city 2, that is this one. So this is the distance from city 1 to city 2 and also distance from city 2 to city 1. So like that, we will calculate the distance between all the cities. So here you can see this is the search space, and in the search space you can see the graph. And here, we all know graph contain vertices, or you can say nodes and edges. So we will consider city as nodes and the edges. Here you can see the edges, that is the distance between the cities. And you can see the edge weight, that is the distance between two cities. And distance to own cities is zero. You can see distance between first city and second city is this one. From city 1 to city 3 is this one. City 1 to city 4 is this one. And from city 2 to city 1 here. From city 2 to city 3, this one. From city 2 to city 4, this one. And from city 3, you can see for 1, 2, 3. And for fourth city, you can see first, second, and third. Using this distance formula, you can calculate the distance for all the cities. After that, now we are going to construct the solution for the first ant. As you can see here in the population, we have four ants. Suppose this is the first ant. Now we will construct the solution for the first ant. First, we will select any city randomly for this ant. Now just imagine that this is the randomly selected city by first ant, that is the fourth city. Now ant is here in the fourth city. Now next step is build the tour from the randomly selected city to the unvisited cities. As you can see here, from fourth city this ant can visit city 1, city 2 and city 3. Now how we will select this? We are using here stochastic mechanism to visit other cities, as you can see here. Now first we will calculate the values for this one, after that this one. Now first you can see the values that we calculated here. Now how the value for the artificial hormone is constant for the first iteration, so this value is same. Now here you can see the value for eta is 1 by distance between city 4 and 1, and distance between city 4 and 1 is 99.8499. So divide 1 by this and we got the value for eta is this one. So like that, calculate the distance for this one, 1 divided by the distance between these two cities and all, and we got the values here. After that, calculate the value for this, that is the sum of all the values that we got here, and we got this. Now we will divide these values. Now we will divide these values and we got the final value. You can see for the city 1, city 2 and for the city 3. Now you can see here we got the values, and for the fourth city you can see this is 0. So now we will construct the solution set. Here you can see this is the solution for the first city, second city, third city and fourth city. So we will add this value in the first solution as it is, then in the first solution add this value, and we got this value for the second city. Then in the second city add this value and we got 1, and in the 1 add 0 and it's again 1. Now select any random value and then we will compare the random value with the solution set. And when the condition is true, it means that city is selected for the tour. Now you can see here for the first city, value is here, this one, condition is false. For the second city, value is again You can see here condition is again unsatisfied, so this is false. For the third city, you can see condition is true. Now third city is selected. Now you can see here fourth city is the randomly selected city, and after that, after some calculation, we got the next city, that is city 3. Now Ant will build the tour from the fourth city to third city, and the distance between fourth city and the third city is this one. You can see here 24.0832. Now we will build the tour again, calculate all the values here, and you can see we got these values. Construct the solution set. Now we want to select the next city, so for that we need to do all this calculation, construct the solution set, and when we compared the values, so for the first city it is satisfied. As you can see here, this value is greater than this one. So now next city that is selected is first city. Now you can see the tour from 3 to 2, now 3 to 1. And the length from 3 to 1, you can see here, from 3 to 1 is this one, 115.1086. Now we will add these two values for the total tour length. So we got the total, this one. Now Rant is here in the first city. Now again we will select new city, that is unvisited. Again construct the solution set, compare the cities, and you can see here for the first city condition is false, and now for the second city this is approximately one, so condition is true. Now we will select the second city. Now we have the next tour from city 1 to 2, and the tour length between city 1 and city 2 is this one, and we got previous value here. Add this tour length also in the total, and we got now the final value for this tour, this one. Now you can see all the cities are visited, you can see in the tour. Now we will make the return trip to the current city. Now we will move the first ant from city 1 to the city 4 and then calculate the tour length, as no unvisited node left. So we need to move the ant from the current city to the initial city from where tour started. Now we can see here, and we will move the ant from the second city to fourth city. So again we have distance, that is this one, so we will add this distance to this value, and we got the final tour length for the first ant is this one. So you can see here, this is the first ant tour, first from city 4 to city 3, then city 3 to city 1, city 1 to city 2, and then 2 to 4, and we got the tour cost 241.4527. Now like that we will calculate the tour length for all three ants one by one. Now for the second ant, just imagine the randomly selected city by this ant is here, this one, third city. See the second ant tour that we got here, 3 to 1, 1 to 4, 4 to 2, 2 to 3. And this is the total tour length that we obtained for second ant. As you can see here, this is the randomly selected city, and after that it visited first city and then fourth city and then second city, and now all the nodes are visited. Now return to the initial city. Done. Now for the third ant, you can see the tour 4 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1, 1 to 4, and this is the tour length. So tour started from here, from 4 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1, 1 to 4, and you can see third ant tour length is 243.3785. Okay, now this is enough. Now in step 12 we will compare the tours. Now we need to find out the feasible truer. You can see here for the three ends, we obtained the tool length, as you can see here. Now we will compare all the tours and find out the feasible one. So for the first end, value is this one. Second end, you can see value is this one. For third end, value is this one. So among all, you can see first end obtained the feasible tour. This is the worst tour as we have maximum distance, and here you can see we have the minimum among all. So we will consider this as the feasible tour. Now this salesperson can follow this route. He can start his tour from 4th city, 4 to 3, 3 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 4, and done. So that's all about this video. And see here, for the first iteration, we obtained the feasible tour for the salesperson. Now in the next iteration, we will update the value for the pheromones for each route. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.